Hi, I'm Salim Ismail. I'm the founding executive director here at Singularity University. I got involved in the founding conference way almost 5 years ago, where we asked the question, is it worth creating an educational organization only based on accelerating technologies? And the observation was made that if you think about the biggest problems in the world, the spread of a pandemic or aspects of climate change or the financial crisis that the world is struggling under, they're rooted in accelerating and exponential factors. Our leadership around the world does not get this phenomena. And this is the fundamental cognitive gap that we're facing. The Arab Spring is a manifestation of that. The younger generation is leveraging information in a way that the older generation can't even conceive of, and that's causing all of that stress that we're seeing. And we're seeing that same stress in Occupy Wall Street, in the patent system, in the legal systems, and so on. When you have an information-based environment, we found it goes into an exponential growth path and it starts doubling in its price performance every 1 to 2 years. And now we have whole industries like music, newspapers, books, all operating on that paradigm and that dynamic. And we are not set up as a world for that. If you think of all of the mechanisms that we use to run the world, our social structure, our civics, our politics, our legal systems, patent systems, healthcare systems, education systems, they're all geared for a world 100 or 200 years ago. We're not set up for the world of today, and definitely not for the world of tomorrow. And all of the changes that we've seen in the last 20 years are mostly due to internet, and mobile is like kind of just starting now, right? Just in the next 10 years, we have 3D printing, we have advanced robotics, we have AI, we have synthetic biology, big data, all coming online. From a societal perspective, we are not set up to absorb that pace of change. And that's why we exist. That's why you are here, is that the next generation of leadership needs to figure out how to navigate these disruptive events in a much more elegant way than we have in the past. Let me give you an example of this. If I take 30 steps linearly, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 30, you can project very well in your heads, where am I 1/3 of the way, where am I 2/3 of the way in that progression. We're very good at that linear extrapolation. If I take 30 doubling steps, 2, 4, 8, 16, at step 30, I'm 26 times around the world. I've gone 1 billion meters. And it's very hard to gauge where am I 1/3 of the way and where am I 2/3 of the way. So that's the shift that we're seeing all around the world in industry after industry, in product area after product area, and that overall pace is, that itself is accelerating. That's why you're here. We want you to think about and have a transitional shift in how you think about the world so you think in this new way so that when you go back to your home countries or whatever industries that you came from or whatever project areas you want to work on, you can take this thinking and apply it so that we end up in a world with abundance. So come learn about these things and go out there and fix the world's problems.